galactic family. The ability to be grateful is a characteristic of happy people. People who lack this ability will often focus on things which are not good. If they do not find it in the present, they will find something in the past that they are angry at, or something that might go wrong in the future. A human being is an anxious and worrisome being, and the current crisis is certainly not reassuring. Existing certainties seem to be falling away. In this article, I want to talk about gratitude as a force that can help you get through a time of crisis and find meaning in it. Every crisis, including this one, marks a break with the past. We are forced to let go of the past, to go inward, and from there to grow into a new future. This is often a painful process. There is a reason why we call it a crisis. The next three steps can help. Be grateful for the past. A crisis often marks a rupture with the past, and sometimes a very radical one. This is what we are seeing in this crisis. Our way of life seems to have changed forever. The old disappears. Many people experience this break with the past as a loss. Beautiful things are over and do not come back, and that causes pain. A lot of anger, frustration, and unhappiness arise from not wanting to accept that the past is over, certainly when we are going to blame others for causing it. In that case, we are going to feel like a victim. But now let us say you sit back and feel truly grateful for all the beautiful things that have happened in the past. Feel what they have given you, feel what they have meant to you. Be truly grateful for it. What happens energetically? The heart opens, radiates to that event in the past and absorbs it. The event is internalized, pulled into the timeless level of the soul. If we do that, we do not need the physical past. All that was valuable in it, through the energy of gratitude, we make part of the timeless reality of our soul. So gratitude is the key to letting go of the past. The key to moving on to the next enriching experience. The meaning of the past. Usually we see the past as something that is over and not coming back, something that is lost forever. We place ourselves in all kinds of boxes as human beings, and the box of time is perhaps the most powerful illusion. I remember a well-known writer agreeing on the heartbreaking pain that the memory of lost beauty can cause forever. But I see that in a different way. I do not think things can get lost forever in the darkness of the night. A flower that once bloomed is always blooming, is forever a part of the timeless universe. What was valuable wants to be immortalized in us. The key, the technique, to doing that is gratitude. If we are not grateful, the past continues to call for our attention, it continues to attract us and creates imbalance. Special events to be thankful for are ultimately always encounters with ourselves. By not being grateful, we reject parts of ourselves, resulting in a fragmentation that always entails a feeling of not being complete, of being unhappy. In life, we continuously meet up with ourselves. Sometimes that is a beautiful encounter, sometimes a painful one. But the key to integration is gratitude. Gratitude makes us whole. Be grateful for the present. A crisis is a radical separation between the past and the future. Often a crisis arises because we hold on to the past for too long, so that the future must forcibly penetrate into the present. A beautiful Dutch expression that describes this is "eventually the shore will turn the ship around." Imagine we are all in a big boat and are firmly convinced that the ship is on course. If someone yells that the ship is heading in the wrong direction, we will not listen because we are partying and everything seems fine. Then it happens, the boat collides with the shore and there is a brutal confrontation with reality. We then have to face reality. We were on the wrong course. The big boat that we imagined to be safe is stuck. We are at the mercy of the elements. What next? lament our fate? Get mad at the captain? I suspect that if someone in such a situation says, "Let's be thankful that this is happening," that no one will be really listening. Still, I would like to try. A crisis is a break with the past. We feel that the past, when things were good, is being stolen from us. We are angry and sad about that. Blaming someone else is tempting, but does not help us much. One question that can help us is this: who were we? Were we really ourselves in that past that felt so comfortable? The way to learn to accept the crisis is to look to the past and really ask yourself the question, was I there? Was I totally present there as a human being with all my potential? If you look at the past before the crisis with complete honesty, you always see something was lacking, something was missing. Part of you was not there. This is the goal of every crisis that you experience, to help you grow, to help you realize your full potential. The real message of every crisis is you are much more beautiful and great than you think. You can do much more than you think. Be grateful for that message. Be grateful for the present. Be grateful for the lost part of yourself that comes to you. By being grateful, you welcome this part. By being grateful, you help yourself to flourish. Be grateful for the future. When we think about the future, we see things that we expect, hope, or fear will happen. These things relate mainly to the outer world. We expect to experience certain things. It is like a part of a movie we have not seen yet. In other words, when we think about the future, we see it primarily as something that is going to happen to us in the world. This stems from a very materialistic view of reality and the progress of time. We can also see time as an inner process we change because our consciousness moves toward completeness. This process does not stop until we are everything. When we are the one. As long as we are not everything, there is an inside and outside world. The growth of consciousness also leads to changes in the outside world. This is what we experience as the progress of time in the outside world. In other words, the changes we see in the outside world are a reflection of our inner growth. In summary, what the future holds is growth, growth of our consciousness. We will discover new dimensions of ourselves. Which ones? We do not know. But the universe is wondrous. We are amazing. Whatever we encounter in the future, it is ours, it is us. Let us receive ourselves in gratitude. The great journey through time is the homecoming to ourselves. Finally, gratitude and duality. There is a little devil in every human being. That little devil tells us something we actually like to hear. Namely, that when something goes wrong, it is not our fault, it is always someone else's fault. So, we are victims. The worldview that the devil gives us is very simple: there are good people and bad people, and we are among the good. So, this worldview divides the world very simply and clearly into good and evil. And if something happens that we do not like, it is because of evil. And that evil is bad and must therefore be fought. The devil preaches duality and we listen. It is nice to be with the good guys. It is nice to be one of the chosen. The problem with this worldview is that it blocks all inner growth. If something bad happens, we cannot do anything about it, or we have to fight it. We maintain duality in this way. We keep listening to the duality devil. Duality blocks growth. How do we eliminate this duality? By eliminating the duality with the devil in us. Why do you not go in there and look at that little devil? That little devil that constantly yells at us that there are bad and nasty things in the world outside of us. Look at that little devil lovingly and say, "I'm glad you're here. You point me to things I still need to learn to love. You show me where I can grow. You're a part of me, but you're not my boss. I'm grateful, Be happy with who you are. Be happy with all facets of yourself. Do not judge yourself any longer, but be grateful for yourself. Be grateful that your consciousness can experience your unique personality. Only then will the fight with yourself end. Only then will you really find yourself in your power. I am the voice of Earth. I greet you all from deep within my heart, the center of this planet. You all are so dear to me, so cherished. You are welcome here on Earth. Reach out your hand to me, I am your partner. Together we enter into this dance of life. Your light has taken the form of a body that was born and made out of me. I am the earthly elements that help you to take on that form and that nourish you. I myself am living consciousness. I am not dead, for with every step you take you can feel the flow of my life force beneath your feet. Feel my resilient, inexhaustible energy and allow it to nourish you. Let my bright, pure earth energy flow up through your legs. My strength is both physical and ethereal. If you allow me to flow into you, not only will your body be strengthened, but also your mind. I feed you with the inspiration you see everywhere in nature, the inspiration of life itself, which grows and blooms and goes its way without doubting itself. Have you ever heard of a flower that has doubts about her destiny to open and to show her gorgeous splendor to the world? Does the flower question whether it is free to feed itself from the soil of the earth or to absorb the rain and sunshine? Have you ever heard of a flower that doubts if it may receive these things? The flower receives more than just material nourishment. It also receives spiritual inspiration from the small ethereal creatures around it, the elves, the nymphs, the fairies that feed it, and encourage it, and praise it. What a joy, what an inspiration is present in nature. If you could see with my eyes, you would then see so much life and inspiration along every path in the forests that you would stand in wonder and let go of your despair. There is so much love, vitality, and creativity on Earth. Connect with that life, with nature, and feel her presence in your body. You are also a flower of the earth who may be nourished with everything it needs. Feel your roots go deep into the soil. Feel the power in your legs and how that power connects you with the earth. Let yourself take root as does a tree. Imagine that you are a tree. A mature, tall tree with a crown that juts high into the air and catches all there is wind, rain, sunshine and takes in all that comes to it in quiet acceptance and surrender. The seasons come and go, and the tree, in its essence, lives in everything that becomes part of it in every moment. No more and no less. Descend farther into the trunk and down into the roots of that tree. Go into the soil with your awareness and feel how the roots actually mirror a complete set of branches, but do so underground. Feel the life active there in the soil and the moisture. Feel the stability and strength of the roots and let go of the tension in your body. There is a root system in you that supports you. Your body is meant to carry you in this life, so trust that it can do so. Feel the natural rhythm of nature that you experience in the tree, and now feel that same rhythm in your own body and surrender to it. Imagine that everything you need at this moment is present in your life. You only need to open your eyes to it. To listen for the signals that come your way. Let us now see what is going on in you and other people who experience themselves as highly sensitive. When you are overwhelmed by impressions from outside yourself that you cannot digest, you experience the burden of your sensitivity. And why is that? Because, at that moment, you are taking in too much of what does not belong to you. You do not have a good connection with your foundation, your trunk, your roots. You could say you have too many branches at the top of your tree, and that causes the things inside you to move and sway too much. You can compare these branches to the higher chakras in your body, the energies of your heart, your throat, the third eye in your head, and your crown chakra. At this time, there is much talk about a transformation on Earth, as well as in the entire solar system in which you dwell. There is an increase in light and awareness, and it is as a wave that engulfs you. You knew this before you came to Earth in this life and you chose to be part of it. Indeed, you have been waiting for this event to happen for a very long time. As a soul, you are old and have lived many lives on Earth, and also on other planets and in other dimensions. There is a shift in consciousness currently taking place in the solar system and I, Earth, have participated in that shift. So what does this shift mean? It means that all living beings on Earth are touched by an impulse, a call to awaken to a remembrance of who they are. You already sensed that impulse before you were born. You knew this was to be an opportunity to deeply incarnate on Earth and to bring clarity and balance to the old burdens you have brought from other lives. You did not come here as a clean slate. Burdens came with you when you were born. And in those burdens is pain, a feeling of being rejected or of not being understood. That pain originated from experiences you had earlier acquired on Earth. Pain has many layers, and each chakra in your energy system has been touched by that old pain, which was triggered again in your youth in this life. I want you to now go to where the pain is most deeply lodged, in the three lower chakras, the abdomen and root chakras. From your higher chakras, you can more easily connect with your innermost being, your soul's light, because it is at this time that your soul's light can be more easily touched and awakened. And this is also what you wanted to happen in your life. You had the desire for awakening, the longing to contribute to the change on Earth. But what you are not sufficiently aware of, at times, is the need to heal the pain that is especially lodged in the lower chakras. And to heal this pain with all the attention and, above all, the patience there is in you. Just focus your awareness on that part of your body, your stomach and abdomen, your pelvis and tailbone, and feel it as a whole. Let your breath descend into this part of your body, wherein is located the home you need to come to. I want to help you to experience a sense of security that you have missed. Something that has not been available to you for a very long time. There is fear in you as a result of not being able to be yourself, of being different. Use your sensitivity to focus on that fear, and just be there with it. Ask yourself what you want to receive there: peace, relaxation, a feeling of security, a sense of belonging, the trust that you can unfold as does a flower? Do you want to be able to count on the natural powers of Earth, as well as of those of the cosmos around you, to help and support you to be your natural self? I want to make you aware of the change that lies before you, and that you are part of that change and can surrender to it. Many things will be arranged for you when you once again dare to surrender to a deep trust in me, Earth, and my creative forces. Surrender to it. And trust me and the light that currently flows through the cosmos. It is time to stand up and to show your deepest inspiration to the world. The world needs you, and not the other way round. You do not need the world to be who you are. You are authentic and loving just as you are. Put your roots deep down into the earth and dare to take care of yourself. Love yourself in those places where you are anxious, worried, or uncertain. Look more deeply into your own pain and surround it with your healing energy. And look to nature to help you, for by connecting with me, you can also experience my healing energy. Finally, I would like to make you aware that there is also help around you from the spirit world, both of heaven and earth. You are used to looking to ascended teachers and angels, but see that there are also guides present here on Earth. Those etheric elves, nymphs, and fairies are also there for you. See if you can feel them around you, because they are there. There are heavenly and earthly guides present here, and they all are dancing around you. They want to share with you their knowledge of joy and ease and what can happen when you trust in life. You human beings are accustomed to trying to control and plan from your head and with your will. You think you need to get a grip on things to somehow keep them from falling apart, but nothing could be farther from the truth. As you align with your deepest feelings and with your heart, and you reach out to the help around you, then life is very clear and easy, and you realize what it is all about, that you are here to flourish and prosper and shine, to do what profoundly feels right for you. You are here to nurture yourself and to become a shining light, a radiant flower that stimulates others by its sheer beauty and joy. Giving and receiving are one when you dare to receive, and to trust, and to spread the light that belongs to you, the light that wants to flow on earth at this time. Trust and feel the help around you. You can feel the energy of the elves in your legs, but do not expect any ponderous advice from them. They are frisky and happy and do not understand why you all have such a difficult time. When they want to tell you something, their advice is simple and direct. Give them your love and appreciation. A smile is enough. They desire to again feel connected with humanity. They want to interact with those of you who have a desire to interact with them. I am so happy that today we have again come together to celebrate the new era. It is no longer something that lies far ahead in the future. It is something which is growing under your feet and blossoming, here and now. A new consciousness, a new knowing is being born in the world. This has to do with the budding energy of the heart in many people, and you are the pioneers, the trailblazers. You are the ones who are the first to carry the seed within you and to plant it on earth. You are light workers, those who carry a deep desire in their soul to spread the light of awareness so there can be more peace, joy, and tolerance on earth. More room to be creative and to share with one another. The freedom to enjoy one another in openness and love without those burdensome obligations, standards, and values you have inherited from your culture and which act as a prison surrounding you. Your desire for change is from your heart, and we are removing the bars from the prison windows. Still, you often hide. You build an imaginary cage around yourself where you wait anxiously and wonder if it is allowed that you establish your new light and radiate it in this world. There are old energies still at work, for the rise of the new can only take place when the old has died away. There first has to be a kind of demise, and it is just before that final moment, when the traditional framework falls away and a new consciousness bursts forth, that the old begins to resist. And it sometimes hits you as fear. Can I do this? Can I be a part of the new? Is there a place in this world for the angel in me? Is the angel in me allowed to express itself here? Can it be of benefit and reach out a hand to others? Can it celebrate life here and share with others in joy and happiness? The mission of your soul on earth is to be the angel you are, which is why you have come here. And make no mistake, you are pioneers, you are trailblazers. Therefore, you do not belong in the old frameworks and structures of the past that are so often based on the power and authority of hierarchical relationships. There are tightly defined roles, especially in work situations, which focus on specific education, or skills, or talents, while the angel in you will not be limited to specifics that can be measured by diplomas or degrees, for example. The angel in you is a pulsating energy that comes from the source of life itself, and it will not be limited by thoughts devised by humans and ideas that do not fit with who you really are. You must learn to be familiar again with that unfettered, free part in the depths of your being. You have become afraid of that part, and even as a child you were made to be wary of it. A child is in possession of a quite spontaneous life flow and enjoys it. How easily a child lives within that spontaneity of feeling, the fluctuating emotions. It also has a very clear desire to do, or to not do, certain things. The child says yes or no very easily and knows what it wants, or does not want. It does not have all those reservations of may I do this or not. The child does not have the same powerful inhibitions as do you. You have amassed a lot of limiting thoughts in the course of your life, yet you are also the ones who have a burning desire in your soul to clear them away. To begin with, this clearing away is something you do for yourself, as well as for others. You become an example for other people when you live in your light, in your greatness. When you dare to manifest, without restrictions, the vibrant energy of the angel within you. If you are not afraid of what others will find, or think, or expect, then you become an angel of light for them. Not because you offer concrete help to them, but by simply being the person you are, a source of light and beauty. Your being that source sparks inspiration in other people, because it feels buoyant, beautiful, and joyous, and you do not need to work hard to achieve that effect. Helping others is not something you do, it is a state of being. Just think of all the teachers who have gone before you that you know from your history, people who have been called masters or saints. They lived from themselves and not from others. They experienced in themselves the source of their own divinity, the angel, and that brought them a delight and an ecstasy that can be difficult to put into words. They experienced the source of their own unlimited being. They brought heaven onto earth, because they experienced no fear of themselves, but radiated who they were, in a limitless way. By just being who they were a beacon of light for other people. People saw their light and wanted to be with them, because those teachers were happy, unburdened, relaxed. And it costs a teacher's no effort. They just focused on that source of light within themselves. The joy and delight they experienced created sparks of inspiration in others. Thus, you need not work for it. Your only job is to find that light within yourself, here and now, and to enjoy it. And to dare live it, for you now are the teachers of the new time. And do not hesitate to take this title, for it is not a matter of ego or arrogance. Simply feel in your soul a deep desire for a change by exposing old rigid structures in order to make them more open, so as to allow a flow of new creativity and freedom and love into the world. That is what you came here to bring. And how do you do that? How do you connect with that vibrant light of the angel, of the light bringer that is in you? You need not try to find it or to struggle for it, because this light is already there, it already flows through you. It gives life to all that you now are, to your feelings, your emotions, your body. Without this light, you would not be present here on earth, so it already exists. It is in all the cells of your body, in your heart, in your feelings. However, it has become covered over in some places more than others by a layer of darkness, or you might say, simply by a layer of not knowing, of not being connected to who you truly are. I would like to discuss that layer in more detail. That layer is the veil of ignorance that you put over yourself when you are not connected with your essential self. Feel that layer inside yourself for a moment, without judging it, but from the light of your consciousness. Feel the tightness of that layer, which can even be physical, but allow it to be there. Feel for a tightness in one of the energy centers in your stomach, or your chest, or your throat, or wherever you sense it. Look at it with a very open mind, yet allow it to be there, because it cannot harm you. You are an angel filled with empathy, compassion, and love for yourself. Imagine for a moment that you simply put a hand on that trapped place in your energy body. A soft caress is sufficient. A gesture that says you may be there, it's okay. I have compassion for you and we can work it out. And then you go deeper into that dark place with your consciousness, into that part that is not able to be who you are. Fear lives there, and maybe also grief and regret and anger. Go toward it. Go to the darkest part in yourself, the part that oppresses you the most, the part that constitutes your prison. We are there with you. We, the ones from the other side who assist you. Each of you has guides and are surrounded by this helping energy, so do not be afraid to look at this darkness in yourself. Look carefully at the blockages, the defenses, you might encounter in that darkness. See if something catches your attention or reaches out to you. And consider the question, why can't I allow my light to shine, or radiate freely in the world? What hinders me? One of the first fears you encounter there that can block you is I can't, I don't know how. I doubt my ability. I am unable to do this. See whether you recognize that thought form in yourself. Who was it told you that? Maybe you see a picture of someone in particular. It may be one of your parents, or someone else from whom you have taken on this doubt of yourself that says I should not be who I am. Allow that thought to pass away, and take the time to do that. What has given you the feeling in this life that I cannot do this? I have to keep a rein on myself. I dare not do this, because it's scary. People will reject or condemn me for who I am. It is too painful to be myself. Gently call up those experiences that have given you that feeling, and look at them from the perspective of the person you really are, the angel in you. Simply put your arms around that pain, around that uncertainty in yourself, and say you can now relax, because I understand your feeling. I am with you. I'm the one who takes care of you. I give you the assurance that you can restore your light. Give yourself that encouragement. Surround yourself with the light of who you are, of the angel in you. The angel in you is not affected by your anxiety. It watches that anxiety with compassion and love, and understands how it came about, yet the angel does not allow itself to be overcome by those emotions. Feel how much greater you are than your fear. Feel that greatness, in spite of the fear you experience. And also accept that you know what you have to do and that you will do it. Feel that in your limbs, your arms and legs, I know who I am, and I know what I have to do. Now we look at another possible blockage, a defense, and that is anger. Fear has to do with being visible to the outside world. You have had many negative experiences there, which can have been in this life, but also farther back in other lives. You may have decided at one point, I don't want to again experience this type of reaction, so I will not allow my light to shine. Thus the will is now lacking for you to allow yourself to be seen. I am angry, so I need to close off myself. There is resistance to allowing yourself to be visible, open, and vulnerable. Many of you carry wounds from your childhood, of when you were still open and spontaneous, and it was there that you encountered negative experiences. Someone made a biting remark, someone rejected your originality, someone stunted your creative flow, and so you suddenly felt, I am not welcome. I am not accepted by this person. And so you shut down a part of yourself. There is pent-up anger as a result of that happening. Well, okay, I am no longer going to be a part of this. And then you closed off yourself and locked yourself within, and you then were in a prison. But at the moment you shut down and closed off yourself, you could not do much else, because often this was the only thing you knew how to do in order to survive, to protect yourself. You had to close the door because you felt, I can't bear this pain of being rejected for who I am. I have to shut down my feelings right now. I can take it. Honor the fact that you reacted that way at the time. That defense mechanism, the closing off of yourself, is very understandable. It is a very human reaction. But now feel how you have become stronger than that pain. You are now able to give yourself the safety and security that was lacking when you were rejected, because you are now more secure within yourself. In your essence, you do not belong to this world, so you do not have to react to the happenings around you. Your being here is about you, and allowing yourself to be who you are. People who cannot accept that will disappear from your life and be replaced by those who belong with you and want to share with you. Do not be afraid of rejection. The fear of rejection is one of the biggest roadblocks you will encounter on your path. And because such a rejection hurts, there has arisen within you an unwillingness to expose yourself. That causes a contracted part, a barrier in your being, about which I spoke earlier. Allow the light to go to that barrier, but do not try to remove it. Simply surround the barrier with caring and compassion, and say I understand. Speak to that contracted part of yourself. You can see it as an angry child, for example, so you can tell it that it may now relax, because you give it the freedom it needs. That you do not care what others think about you, because you know what is right for you. I am who I am. I am welcome here. I bear my light with pride and dignity. I hurt no one with my light. I am simply who I am, especially in this time of change and transition. During this time of change in the field of consciousness in the world, you may feel a strong urge to again go outward with your light and to be of assistance to this change of awareness. And that is when you can meet up with your deepest barriers and defenses, the fear and reluctance to put yourself forward as an angel of light. It is a question of seeing those defenses in yourself and embracing them with love, and forgiving yourself for the necessary measures you once had to take when you closed off yourself. Doing this helps you to again come closer to the core of who you are, the vibrant angel. The more you become your own friend, the happier you will be, and the more signals you will get from your higher self, your angel self, of what you have to do, and of what is enjoyable to do and makes you happy. Do not be afraid to let go of old structures, whether it be a particular type of work, or a certain ingrained thought pattern. There is something new awaiting you. It is not a specifically defined way of doing things, because you are the ones who are creating new ways of cooperating in the world, new ways of working together. You do not fit into existing structures, because you are the creators of new structures that are more flexible and more attuned to the consciousness of the heart. That is why I am asking you to trust that source in yourself, that pulsating light. And the time is right for you, because you will be helped and supported when you dare to trust and to again open up. When you fully connect with the source in yourself. This is the right time. Today, more than ever, there is a need for people like you who are willing to freely and openly share their light. People are needed who have the courage not to live by the usual expectations and who are willing to be seen as different. People who really dare to look directly at another person with a straightforward and open gaze and who clasp hands in joyful welcome. The time is now ready for you, and more importantly, it is your own destiny, your own intention, which has brought you here. Thus, the source of your greatest joy is to be able to live in the light, to be totally who you are. Do not hesitate to do what you feel you want to do. That feeling is your guide, for it brings you to where you need to be. Thank you all for the perseverance and the courage you have already shown in finding your way. You do not give up. You do not settle for less than the truth. That is why you really are the pioneers and trailblazers of the new on Earth, and I thank you for being that. We who are here with you, I and those with me, represent the Christ energy. But you are the ones who allow it to be born on Earth and who live it. And for that, you have our deepest appreciation and respect. Thank you for coming. The ability to be grateful is a characteristic of happy people. People who lack this ability will often focus on things which are not good. If they do not find it in the present, they will find something in the past that they are angry at, or something that might go wrong in the future. A human being is an anxious and worrisome being, and the current crisis is certainly not reassuring. Existing certainties seem to be falling away. In this article, I want to talk about gratitude as a force that can help you get through a time of crisis and find meaning in it. Every crisis, including this one, marks a break with the past. We are forced to let go of the past, to go inward, and from there to grow into a new future. This is often a painful process. There is a reason why we call it a crisis. The next three steps can help. Be grateful for the past. A crisis often marks a rupture with the past, and sometimes a very radical one. This is what we are seeing in this crisis. Our way of life seems to have changed forever. The old disappears. Many people experience this break with the past as a loss. Beautiful things are over and do not come back, and that causes pain. A lot of anger, frustration, and unhappiness arise from not wanting to accept that the past is over, certainly when we are going to blame others for causing it. In that case, we are going to feel like a victim. But now let us say you sit back and feel truly grateful for all the beautiful things that have happened in the past. Feel what they have given you, feel what they have meant to you. Be truly grateful for it. What happens energetically? The heart opens, radiates to that event in the past and absorbs it. The event is internalized, pulled into the timeless level of the soul. If we do that, we do not need the physical past. All that was valuable in it, through the energy of gratitude, we make part of the timeless reality of our soul. So gratitude is the key to letting go of the past. The key to moving on to the next enriching experience. The meaning of the past. Usually we see the past as something that is over and not coming back, something that is lost forever. We place ourselves in all kinds of boxes as human beings, and the box of time is perhaps the most powerful illusion. I remember a well-known writer agreeing on the heartbreaking pain that the memory of lost beauty can cause forever. But I see that in a different way. I do not think things can get lost forever in the darkness of the night. A flower that once bloomed is always blooming, is forever a part of the timeless universe. What was valuable wants to be immortalized in us. The key, the technique, to doing that is gratitude. If we are not grateful, the past continues to call for our attention, it continues to attract us and creates imbalance. Special events to be thankful for are ultimately always encounters with ourselves. By not being grateful, we reject parts of ourselves, resulting in a fragmentation that always entails a feeling of not being complete, of being unhappy. In life, we continuously meet up with ourselves. Sometimes that is a beautiful encounter, sometimes a painful one. But the key to integration is gratitude. Gratitude makes us whole. Be grateful for the present. A crisis is a radical separation between the past and the future. Often a crisis arises because we hold on to the past for too long, so that the future must forcibly penetrate into the present. A beautiful Dutch expression that describes this is "eventually the shore will turn the ship around." Imagine we are all in a big boat and are firmly convinced that the ship is on course. If someone yells that the ship is heading in the wrong direction, we will not listen because we are partying and everything seems fine. Then it happens, the boat collides with the shore and there is a brutal confrontation with reality. We then have to face reality. We were on the wrong course. The big boat that we imagined to be safe is stuck. We are at the mercy of the elements. What next? Lament our fate? Get mad at the captain? I suspect that if someone in such a situation says, "Let's be thankful that this is happening," that no one will be really listening. Still, I would like to try. A crisis is a break with the past. We feel that the past, when things were good, is being stolen from us. We are angry and sad about that. Blaming someone else is tempting, but does not help us much. One question that can help us is this: who were we? Were we really ourselves in that past that felt so comfortable? The way to learn to accept the crisis is to look to the past and really ask yourself the question: was I there? Was I totally present there as a human being with all my potential? If you look at the past before the crisis with complete honesty, you always see something was lacking, something was missing. Part of you was not there. This is the goal of every crisis that you experience, to help you grow, to help you realize your full potential. The real message of every crisis is you are much more beautiful and great than you think. You can do much more than you think. Be grateful for that message. Be grateful for the present. Be grateful for the lost part of yourself that comes to you. By being grateful, you welcome this part. By being grateful, you help yourself to flourish. Be grateful for the future. When we think about the future, we see things that we expect, hope, or fear will happen. These things relate mainly to the outer world. We expect to experience certain things. It is like a part of a movie we have not seen yet. In other words, when we think about the future, we see it primarily as something that is going to happen to us in the world. This stems from a very materialistic view of reality and the progress of time. We can also see time as an inner process we change because our consciousness moves toward completeness. This process does not stop until we are everything. When we are the one. As long as we are not everything, there is an inside and outside world. The growth of consciousness also leads to changes in the outside world. This is what we experience as the progress of time in the outside world. In other words, the changes we see in the outside world are a reflection of our inner growth. In summary, what the future holds is growth, growth of our consciousness. We will discover new dimensions of ourselves. Which ones? We do not know. But the universe is wondrous. We are amazing. Whatever we encounter in the future, it is ours, it is us. Let us receive ourselves in gratitude. The great journey through time is the homecoming to ourselves. Finally, gratitude and duality. There is a little devil in every human being. That little devil tells us something we actually like to hear. Namely, that when something goes wrong, it is not our fault, it is always someone else's fault. So, we are victims. The worldview that the devil gives us is very simple: there are good people and bad people, and we are among the good. So, this worldview divides the world very simply and clearly into good and evil. And if something happens that we do not like, it is because of evil. And that evil is bad and must therefore be fought. The devil preaches duality and we listen. It is nice to be with the good guys. It is nice to be one of the chosen. The problem with this worldview is that it blocks all inner growth. If something bad happens, we cannot do anything about it, or we have to fight it. We maintain duality in this way. We keep listening to the duality devil. Duality blocks growth. How do we eliminate this duality? By eliminating the duality with the devil in us. Why do you not go in there and look at that little devil? That little devil that constantly yells at us that there are bad and nasty things in the world outside of us. Look at that little devil lovingly and say, "I'm glad you're here. You point me to things I still need to learn to love, you show me where I can grow. You're a part of me, but you're not my boss. I'm grateful. Be happy with who you are. Be happy with all facets of yourself. Do not judge yourself any longer, but be grateful for yourself. Be grateful that your consciousness can experience your unique personality. Only then will the fight with yourself end. Only then will you really find yourself in your power. I am the voice of Earth. I greet you all from deep within my heart, the center of this planet. You all are so dear to me, so cherished. You are welcome here on Earth. Reach out your hand to me, I am your partner. Together we enter into this dance of life. Your light has taken the form of a body that was born and made out of me. I am the earthly elements that help you to take on that form and that nourish you. I myself am living consciousness. I am not dead, for with every step you take you can feel the flow of my life force beneath your feet. Feel my resilient, inexhaustible energy and allow it to nourish you. Let my bright, pure earth energy flow up through your legs. My strength is both physical and ethereal. If you allow me to flow into you, not only will your body be strengthened, but also your mind. I feed you with the inspiration you see everywhere in nature, the inspiration of life itself, which grows and blooms and goes its way without doubting itself. Have you ever heard of a flower that has doubts about her destiny to open and to show her gorgeous splendor to the world? Does the flower question whether it is free to feed itself from the soil of the earth or to absorb the rain and sunshine? Have you ever heard of a flower that doubts if it may receive these things? The flower receives more than just material nourishment. It also receives spiritual inspiration from the small ethereal creatures around it, the elves, the nymphs, the fairies that feed it, and encourage it, and praise it. What a joy, what an inspiration is present in nature. If you could see with my eyes, you would then see so much life and inspiration along every path in the forests that you would stand in wonder and let go of your despair. There is so much love, vitality, and creativity on Earth. Connect with that life, with nature, and feel her presence in your body. You are also a flower of the earth who may be nourished with everything it needs. Feel your roots go deep into the soil. Feel the power in your legs and how that power connects you with the earth. Let yourself take root as does a tree. Imagine that you are a tree. A mature, tall tree with a crown that juts high into the air and catches all there is wind, rain, sunshine and takes in all that comes to it in quiet acceptance and surrender. The seasons come and go, and the tree, in its essence, lives in everything that becomes part of it in every moment. No more and no less. Descend farther into the trunk and down into the roots of that tree. Go into the soil with your awareness and feel how the roots actually mirror a complete set of branches, but do so underground. Feel the life active there in the soil and the moisture. Feel the stability and strength of the roots and let go of the tension in your body. There is a root system in you that supports you. Your body is meant to carry you in this life, so trust that it can do so. Feel the natural rhythm of nature that you experience in the tree, and now feel that same rhythm in your own body and surrender to it. Imagine that everything you need at this moment is present in your life. You only need to open your eyes to it, to listen for the signals that come your way. Let us now see what is going on in you and other people who experience themselves as highly sensitive. When you are overwhelmed by impressions from outside yourself that you cannot digest, you experience the burden of your sensitivity. And why is that? Because, at that moment, you are taking in too much of what does not belong to you. You do not have a good connection with your foundation, your trunk, your roots. You could say you have too many branches at the top of your tree, and that causes the things inside you to move and sway too much. You can compare these branches to the higher chakras in your body, the energies of your heart, your throat, the third eye in your head, and your crown chakra. At this time, there is much talk about a transformation on Earth, as well as in the entire solar system in which you dwell. There is an increase in light and awareness, and it is as a wave that engulfs you. You knew this before you came to Earth in this life, and you chose to be part of it. Indeed, you have been waiting for this event to happen for a very long time. As a soul, you are old and have lived many lives on Earth, and also on other planets and in other dimensions. There is a shift in consciousness currently taking place in the solar system, and I, Earth, have participated in that shift. So what does this shift mean? It means that all living beings on Earth are touched by an impulse, a call to awaken to a remembrance of who they are. You already sensed that impulse before you were born. You knew this was to be an opportunity to deeply incarnate on Earth and to bring clarity and balance to the old burdens you have brought from other lives. You did not come here as a clean slate. Burdens came with you when you were born, and in those burdens is pain, a feeling of being rejected or of not being understood. That pain originated from experiences you had earlier acquired on Earth. Pain has many layers, and each chakra in your energy system has been touched by that old pain, which was triggered again in your youth in this life. I want you to now go to where the pain is most deeply lodged, in the three lower chakras, the abdomen and root chakras. From your higher chakras, you can more easily connect with your innermost being, your soul's light, because it is at this time that your soul's light can be more easily touched and awakened. And this is also what you wanted to happen in your life. You had the desire for awakening, the longing to contribute to the change on Earth. But what you are not sufficiently aware of, at times, is the need to heal the pain that is especially lodged in the lower chakras, and to heal this pain with all the attention and, above all, the patience there is in you. Just focus your awareness on that part of your body, your stomach and abdomen, your pelvis and tailbone, and feel it as a whole. Let your breath descend into this part of your body, wherein is located the home you need to come to. I want to help you to experience a sense of security that you have missed, something that has not been available to you for a very long time. There is fear in you as a result of not being able to be yourself, of being different. Use your sensitivity to focus on that fear, and just be there with it. Ask yourself what you want to receive there: peace, relaxation, a feeling of security, a sense of belonging, the trust that you can unfold as does a flower? Do you want to be able to count on the natural powers of Earth, as well as of those of the cosmos around you, to help and support you to be your natural self? I want to make you aware of the change that lies before you, and that you are part of that change and can surrender to it. Many things will be arranged for you when you once again dare to surrender to a deep trust in me, Earth, and my creative forces. Surrender to it, and trust me and the light that currently flows through the cosmos. It is time to stand up and to show your deepest inspiration to the world. The world needs you, and not the other way around. You do not need the world to be who you are. You are authentic and loving just as you are. Put your roots deep down into the earth and dare to take care of yourself. Love yourself in those places where you are anxious, worried, or uncertain. Look more deeply into your own pain and surround it with your healing energy. And look to nature to help you, for by connecting with me, you can also experience my healing energy. Finally, I would like to make you aware that there is also help around you from the spirit world, both of heaven and earth. You are used to looking to ascended teachers and angels, but see that there are also guides present here on Earth. Those etheric elves, nymphs, and fairies are also there for you. See if you can feel them around you, because they are there. There are heavenly and earthly guides present here, and they all are dancing around you. They want to share with you their knowledge of joy and ease and what can happen when you trust in life. You human beings are accustomed to trying to control and plan from your head and with your will. You think you need to get a grip on things to somehow keep them from falling apart, but nothing could be farther from the truth. As you align with your deepest feelings and with your heart, and you reach out to the help around you, then life is very clear and easy, and you realize what it is all about, that you are here to flourish and prosper and shine, to do what profoundly feels right for you. You are here to nurture yourself and to become a shining light, a radiant flower that stimulates others by its sheer beauty and joy. Giving and receiving are one when you dare to receive, and to trust, and to spread the light that belongs to you, the light that wants to flow on earth at this time. Trust and feel the help around you. You can feel the energy of the elves in your legs, but do not expect any ponderous advice from them. They are frisky and happy and do not understand why you all have such a difficult time. When they want to tell you something, their advice is simple and direct. Give them your love and appreciation, a smile is enough. They desire to again feel connected with humanity. They want to interact with those of you who have a desire to interact with them. I am so happy that today we have again come together to celebrate the new era. It is no longer something that lies far ahead in the future. It is something which is growing under your feet and blossoming, here and now. A new consciousness, a new knowing is being born in the world. This has to do with the budding energy of the heart in many people, and you are the pioneers, the trailblazers. You are the ones who are the first to carry the seed within you and to plant it on earth. You are light workers, those who carry a deep desire in their soul to spread the light of awareness so there can be more peace, joy, and tolerance on earth. More room to be creative and to share with one another. The freedom to enjoy one another in openness and love without those burdensome obligations, standards, and values you have inherited from your culture and which act as a prism surrounding you. Your desire for change is from your heart, and we are removing the bars from the prison windows. Still, you often hide. You build an imaginary cage around yourself where you wait anxiously and wonder if it is allowed that you establish your new light and radiate it in this world. There are old energies still at work, for the rise of the new can only take place when the old has died away. There first has to be a kind of demise, and it is just before that final moment, when the traditional framework falls away and a new consciousness bursts forth, that the old begins to resist. And it sometimes hits you as fear: can I do this? Can I be a part of the new? Is there a place in this world for the angel in me? Is the angel in me allowed to express itself here? Can it be of benefit and reach out a hand to others? Can it celebrate life here and share with others in joy and happiness? The mission of your soul on earth is to be the angel you are, which is why you have come here. And make no mistake, you are pioneers, you are trailblazers. Therefore, you do not belong in the old frameworks and structures of the past that are so often based on the power and authority of hierarchical relationships. There are tightly defined roles, especially in work situations, which focus on specific education, or skills, or talents, while the angel in you will not be limited to specifics that can be measured by diplomas or degrees, for example. The angel in you is a pulsating energy that comes from the source of life itself, and it will not be limited by thoughts devised by humans and ideas that do not fit with who you really are. You must learn to be familiar again with that unfettered, free part in the depths of your being. You have become afraid of that part, and even as a child you were made to be wary of it. A child is in possession of a quite spontaneous life flow and enjoys it. How easily a child lives within that spontaneity of feeling, the fluctuating emotions. It also has a very clear desire to do, or to not do, certain things. The child says yes or no very easily and knows what it wants, or does not want. It does not have all those reservations of may I do this or not. The child does not have the same powerful inhibitions as do you. You have amassed a lot of limiting thoughts in the course of your life, yet you are also the ones who have a burning desire in your soul to clear them away. To begin with, this clearing away is something you do for yourself, as well as for others. You become an example for other people when you live in your light, in your greatness. When you dare to manifest, without restrictions, the vibrant energy of the angel within you. If you are not afraid of what others will find, or think, or expect, then you become an angel of light for them. Not because you offer concrete help to them, but by simply being the person you are, a source of light and beauty. Your being that source sparks inspiration in other people, because it feels buoyant, beautiful, and joyous, and you do not need to work hard to achieve that effect. Helping others is not something you do, it is a state of being. Just think of all the teachers who have gone before you that you know from your history, people who have been called masters or saints. They lived from themselves and not from others. They experienced in themselves the source of their own divinity, the angel, and that brought them a delight and an ecstasy that can be difficult to put into words. They experienced the source of their own unlimited being. They brought heaven onto earth, because they experienced no fear of themselves, but radiated who they were, in a limitless way. By just being who they were a beacon of light for other people. People saw their light and wanted to be with them, because those teachers were happy, unburdened, relaxed. And it costs the teachers no effort. They just focused on that source of light within themselves. The joy and delight they experienced created sparks of inspiration in others. Thus, you need not work for it. Your only job is to find that light within yourself, here and now, and to enjoy it, and to dare live it, for you now are the teachers of the new time. And do not hesitate to take this title, for it is not a matter of ego or arrogance. Simply feel in your soul a deep desire for a change by exposing old rigid structures in order to make them more open, so as to allow a flow of new creativity and freedom and love into the world. That is what you came here to bring. And how do you do that? How do you connect with that vibrant light of the angel, of the light bringer that is in you? You need not try to find it or to struggle for it, because this light is already there, it already flows through you. It gives life to all that you now are, to your feelings, your emotions, your body. Without this light, you would not be present here on earth, so it already exists. It is in all the cells of your body, in your heart, in your feelings. However, it has become covered over in some places more than others by a layer of darkness, or you might say, simply by a layer of not knowing, of not being connected to who you truly are. I would like to discuss that layer in more detail. That layer is the veil of ignorance that you put over yourself when you are not connected with your essential self. Feel that layer inside yourself for a moment, without judging it, but from the light of your consciousness. Feel the tightness of that layer, which can even be physical, but allow it to be there. Feel for a tightness in one of the energy centers in your stomach, or your chest, or your throat, or wherever you sense it. Look at it with a very open mind, yet allow it to be there, because it cannot harm you. You are an angel filled with empathy, compassion, and love for yourself. Imagine for a moment that you simply put a hand on that trapped place in your energy body. A soft caress is sufficient. A gesture that says you may be there, it's okay. I have compassion for you and we can work it out. And then you go deeper into that dark place with your consciousness, into that part that is not able to be who you are. Fear lives there, and maybe also grief and regret and anger. Go toward it. Go to the darkest part in yourself, the part that oppresses you the most, the part that constitutes your prison. We are there with you. We, the ones from the other side who assist you. Each of you has guides and are surrounded by this helping energy, so do not be afraid to look at this darkness in yourself. Look carefully at the blockages, the defenses, you might encounter in that darkness. See if something catches your attention or reaches out to you. And consider the question, why can't I allow my light to shine, or radiate freely in the world? What hinders me? One of the first fears you encounter there that can block you is, I can't, I don't know how. I doubt my ability. I am unable to do this. See whether you recognize that thought form in yourself. Who has it told you that? Maybe you see a picture of someone in particular. It may be one of your parents, or someone else from whom you have taken on this doubt of yourself that says, I should not be who I am. Allow that thought to pass away, and take the time to do that. What has given you the feeling in this life that I cannot do this? I have to keep a rein on myself. I dare not do this, because it's scary. People will reject or condemn me for who I am. It is too painful to be myself. Gently call up those experiences that have given you that feeling, and look at them from the perspective of the person you really are, the angel in you. Simply put your arms around that pain, around that uncertainty in yourself, and say, you can now relax, because I understand your feeling. I am with you. I'm the one who takes care of you. I give you the assurance that you can restore your light. Give yourself that encouragement. Surround yourself with the light of who you are, of the angel in you. The angel in you is not affected by your anxiety. It watches that anxiety with compassion and love, and understands how it came about, yet the angel does not allow itself to be overcome by those emotions. Feel how much greater you are than your fear. Feel the greatness, in spite of the fear you experience. And also accept that you know what you have to do and that you will do it. Feel that in your limbs, your arms and legs, I know who I am, and I know what I have to do. Now we look at another possible blockage, a defense, and that is anger. Fear has to do with being visible to the outside world. You have had many negative experiences there, which can have been in this life, but also farther back in other lives. You may have decided at one point, I don't want to again experience this type of reaction, so I will not allow my light to shine. Thus the will is now lacking for you to allow yourself to be seen. I am angry, so I need to close off myself. There is resistance to allowing yourself to be visible, open, and vulnerable. Many of you carry wounds from your childhood, of when you were still open and spontaneous, and it was there that you encountered negative experiences. Someone made a biting remark, someone rejected your originality, someone stunted your creative flow, and so you suddenly felt, I am not welcome. I am not accepted by this person. And so you shut down a part of yourself. There is pent-up anger as a result of that happening. Well, okay, I am no longer going to be a part of this. And then you closed off yourself and locked yourself within, and you then were in a prison. But at the moment you shut down and closed off yourself, you could not do much else, because often this was the only thing you knew how to do in order to survive, to protect yourself. You had to close the door because you felt, I can't bear this pain of being rejected for who I am. I have to shut down my feelings right now. I can take it. Honor the fact that you reacted that way at the time. That defense mechanism, the closing off of yourself, is very understandable. It is a very human reaction. But now feel how you have become stronger than that pain. You are now able to give yourself the safety and security that was lacking when you were rejected, because you are now more secure within yourself. In your essence, you do not belong to this world, so you do not have to react to the happenings around you. Your being here is about you, and allowing yourself to be who you are. People who cannot accept that will disappear from your life and be replaced by those who belong with you and want to share with you. Do not be afraid of rejection. The fear of rejection is one of the biggest roadblocks you will encounter on your path. And because such a rejection hurts, there has arisen within you an unwillingness to expose yourself. That causes a contracted part, a barrier in your being, about which I spoke earlier. Allow the light to go to that barrier, but do not try to remove it. Simply surround the barrier with caring and compassion, and say, "I understand." Speak to that contracted part of yourself. You can see it as an angry child, for example, so you can tell it that it may now relax, because you give it the freedom it needs. That you do not care what others think about you, because you know what is right for you. "I am who I am. I am welcome here. I bear my light with pride and dignity. I hurt no one with my light. I am simply who I am, especially in this time of change and transition." During this time of change in the field of consciousness in the world, you may feel a strong urge to again go outward with your light and to be of assistance to this change of awareness. And that is when you can meet up with your deepest barriers and defenses, the fear and reluctance to put yourself forward as an angel of light. It is a question of seeing those defenses in yourself and embracing them with love, and forgiving yourself for the necessary measures you once had to take when you closed off yourself. Doing this helps you to again come closer to the core of who you are, the vibrant angel. The more you become your own friend, the happier you will be, and the more signals you will get from your higher self, your angel self, of what you have to do, and of what is enjoyable to do and makes you happy. Do not be afraid to let go of old structures, whether it be a particular type of work, or a certain ingrained thought pattern. There is something new awaiting you. It is not a specifically defined way of doing things, because you are the ones who are creating new ways of cooperating in the world, new ways of working together. You do not fit into existing structures, because you are the creators of new structures that are more flexible and more attuned to the consciousness of the heart. That is why I am asking you to trust that source in yourself, that pulsating light. And the time is right for you, because you will be helped and supported when you dare to trust and to again open up. When you fully connect with the source in yourself. This is the right time. Today, more than ever, there is a need for people like you who are willing to freely and openly share their light. People are needed who have the courage not to live by the usual expectations and who are willing to be seen as different. People who really dare to look directly at another person with a straightforward and open gaze and who clasp hands in joyful welcome. The time is now ready for you, and more importantly, it is your own destiny, your own intention, which has brought you here. Thus, the source of your greatest joy is to be able to live in the light, to be totally who you are. Do not hesitate to do what you feel you want to do. That feeling is your guide, for it brings you to where you need to be. Thank you all for the perseverance and the courage you have already shown in finding your way. You do not give up. You do not settle for less than the truth. That is why you really are the pioneers and trailblazers of the new on Earth, and I thank you for being that. We who are here with you, I and those with me, represent the Christ energy. But you are the ones who allow it to be born on Earth and who live it. And for that, you have our deepest appreciation and respect. Thank you for coming.